The Pharaohs team consists of three sections: mechanical, electrical, and science. The mechanical team, electrical team, science team. One of our management considerations this year was focusing on the development of the team. The tally on the left shows each member's skill level from day one. A training program is developed and implemented, then the member's skills are shown again at the end of the year. In this summary, red shows the required number of members determined by the team leaders. Yellow and blue show the number of members with that skill level. Before manufacturing, the chase's performance was tested using gazebo simulation. Problems identified in the simulation, such as continuous rotation of the bogey, were solved beforehand, in this case using mechanical stoppers, saving us time and money. The required torque was calculated and treads were manufactured to generate the required traction for the rover. A 6 degrees of freedom robotic arm was manufactured at the Arab Organization for Industrialization, and the gripper was manufactured internally using our 3D printer. The web API allows the rover to be easily controlled using any web-enabled device, provides the up-to-date status of the rover's subsystems, and allows the rover to be station independent. All communication between the control system and the rover are over IP. We use Wi-Fi boosters to enhance the communication link and selected the best commercial communication system. Here we see a live simulation on gazebo that is controlled first using a joystick and then by manipulating a prototype arm. Autonomous control uses data from several standard sources as well as satellite pictures that produce an occupancy grid, which helps the rover with path planning. Once a global path is set, image processing to detect obstacles is used to develop subpaths. After arrival at the target location, image processing is further used to find the gate indicator and approach it. The rover's power levels are monitored throughout the operation to avoid any unplanned behavior. We are currently testing the rover's capabilities to achieve the URC's required tasks. For the in-lab experiment, this year we will be testing for DNA and RNA using the two tests shown here, as well as other biomarkers that would indicate whether life exists. In this controlled experiment, we see the result of two samples, one with and the other without a DPA solution. We improved our understanding of the different types of rocks by collecting a large database of rock properties. Our mechanical team developed the shovel in order to achieve the soil depth required. Bearing in mind the no-spill policy, our science box has a capacity of 6 onboard wet tests. Its sensors allow for the collection of soil and environmental readings.